Oh, as a final little note, see, you know, I was looking at the get pixel and put pixel, set pixel methods, which again are similar to the some of the methods available in VB6. And of course, wouldn't you know it, that's on MSDN. So, you know, which is a whole other fucking gob of gobbledygook. You know, bitmap class, system drawing, bitmap methods. So, you know, like I said, you know, we got all this crap over here too, which I'm, you know, and here's the get pixel method, so putting them into my C graphics library. I guess I could actually drag a copy of this down to our thing here too. Bitmap get pixel method, bitmap put pixel method. But at any rate, yeah, that's what I was saying, you know, in some of the previous videos, you know, is that there is just a whole smorgasbord of other fucking information that, you know, because I didn't see any reference at all to this in the research I did today, you know, about get pixel and set pixel, so. You know, and it's really much worse over here on this, because, you know, how this fucking thing works, I don't know. You know, I feel like saying no on everything. But like I said, they don't have PDFs that you can download here like they do on the other site. So, but I have no idea how this site is organized. I've spent very little time over here, you know, browsing around the MSDN thing. I know MSDN used to be a long time ago, back in the VB5 and 6 days, a premium service. I don't know if it still is. That's why I'm, you know, kind of reluctant to say what we got here. Okay, bitmap constructor, bitmap methods. Okay, so are these the bitmap methods? They don't look like all the methods. You know, where's the set pixel or get pixel? Okay, so we got, well, hell, at least this lists out the methods of some of these things. That's good. And we got get pixel, get type, save string, yeah, set pixel, here we go. So yeah, I'll save this and plop this in here too. So walkthroughs, no, that's not what it is. Where'd it go? Bitmap method system drawing, so that's where that went. So, anyway, at least this is organized more conventionally, you know, because that's still what's kind of, I don't know, throwing me for a bit of a loop, is that, you know, I just expect to see some of this stuff organized differently, or presented differently. Okay, we've got a syntax there, but where all the, like, methods and properties and all the shit that, you know, relates to this command. So, or are there any? I don't know. I mean, you know, it gets kind of confusing. It's just, that's why it's hard to get a bird's eye view, you know, because there's not, like in C++ or whatever, you know, there's not a big listing. You know, you can go to a lot of websites with a lot of listing that lists all the methods and properties and exceptions and just everything, you know, and you can delve in, you know, but you can read little descriptions of everything and, you know, etc., you know, with C++, but, you know, you can't do that so easily here, so it's a little bit underwhelming. So, yeah, this is the same docs site, so optimizing graphics and imaging. Let's looks like it's, I don't know, this looks like a different, yeah, this is WPF stuff right here, apparently, so, I guess I'll fucking drop links, though, in my little reservoir down here so you can find all this stuff again, because it's, you know, I just fucking hate Chrome. I hate the fucking bookmark organization it has. I do have a little bar, you know, that I downloaded right here, a simple bookmark bar. It's nice. It's a lot like, you know, it's a lot like Explorer, you know, because I still like Explorer because you can actually organize your shit really well in it. You know, I mean, it's like I said, you know, I got all these folders and subfolders and, you know, I mean, you can really organize stuff nicely, and it's easy to get to. It's always, you know, on the left-hand side here, etc. You know, it's just, you know, it's great to have this kind of organization. So, you know, you can really organize your shit in Explorer, but I can't do that in fucking Google Chrome for anything. And, you know, it looks like Edge, they've started doing something kind of like that, but I don't know. I mean, I just still haven't really gotten into Edge, because you can make your favorites pop up, but I still prefer it on the left, but I still don't really know that you can add stuff with the same efficiency, you know, as you can in Explorer, so... But since Explorer, you know, it's not really kept up well by Microsoft, they don't really use it much anymore, so that's why I'm on fucking Chrome. As I just still don't know what to make of Edge, honestly. But, anyway, yeah, I don't really need, you know, to worry too much about this stuff, right now. I'm gonna have to wait, you know, because I mean, you know, like I said, this is, it's a too, you know, it's a lot to take in, just all the .NET shit that's been changed, you know, as far as Windows Forms programming is concerned, because I got thousands of fucking hours of Windows programming under VB 5 and 6, spread out over the last, you know, 15, 20 years, but the fact of the matter is that things have changed a lot. So it's a lot to take in, just trying to salvage my skill and knowledge from VB6, you know, and apply it to .NET on forms, let alone worry about something totally new like this WPF stuff. So, you know, so I'm really trying to, you know, trying to take the path that gets me to where I can do useful coding as quickly as possible, and that's going to be through Windows Forms. You know, WPF is still, you know, a different animal, and I just don't really want to mess around with it, and, you know, as much just yet. I mean, that's going to have to wait until I'm, you know, as confident on programming in C# as I am on VB6. So, you know, because I can do just about anything in VB6, you know, any kind of application anyway. So, you know, because I understand how it works, I understand how the controls work. Here, you know, I'm still trying to find my ass from my elbows, you know what I mean? So, okay, this is just about the mass text box, and that's in the Windows Forms controls. Which I left this up because I thought it was a good control reference. Let me see. Windows Form Controls. I'll just go ahead and I'll go ahead and put that in graphics too, but I'll drop this in my little thing, so I've got a reference to it for the future. So I can close that. What is a XAML page? Don't know the answer to that. Maybe I'll learn that one day. The difference between that and a form or whatever their whatever their XAML version of the form was. Okay, C# guide. is this a C-sharp guide. Like I said, I got this downloaded and everything in here. That's what all this shit is. So C-sharp concepts, you know, you'll see it's right here. Okay, and that's C-sharp guide, but I mean, I downloaded PDFs and bookmarks and most of this shit. So I can close that. But at any rate, you know, that I'm closing all my tabs finally on C#. I'll leave this up just in case I need to browse for something relating to Visual Basic. But again, I'm not going to spend a lot of time on it. In the future, I'd just rather focus on C#. And by focusing on C#, hell, I'll learn 90% of what I need to know in Visual Basic anyway, because most of my confusion will be with the .NET crap. So, anyway.